Hello, let's go.
So, are you ready to get to work?
Yes, ma'am.
Or was there something else? I don't know what you've heard, but I can imagine. First of all, I think you can dismiss any stories about us no longer existing. I don't believe in smearing our name everywhere we can. Exploring the universe, charting the unknown, that's what counts. Besides, having a little mystery gives us room to maneuver. A fixed reputation could fence us in a lot of ways.
Yeah, but I mean, you might re-exist, you know, like how the Black Panther Party then became the new Black Panther Party, which are two entirely different things. I'm just saying.
We're going to be doing some old-fashioned detective work.
Ooh.
The artifacts are relatively inert once they're out of bedrock. That means people can pass them around, not even knowing what they are. I've been letting my contacts know to be on the lookout for strange metal objects. Get back a lot of noise, usually. But a tip from the UC Vanguard sounds promising. A volunteer force that helps defend the edges of United Colonies space.
Ooh.
They're always looking for recruits. Lots of retired veterans and dangerous professionals mixed in with part-timers who barely have a laser cannon welded to a hull. My contact is in the recruiting office, so he hears a lot about what the volunteers are up to. Jumping to anthropology on me already? Oh, well, good. We all need our own reasons to be out there. But it's not just that. I want to take this opportunity to see how you handle yourself.
What's anthropology?
And for you to learn more about us. I'm going to be sticking with you for this. We'll be traveling together until we either find an artifact or this lead runs dry. You mean besides the ship, the robot, and a place to stay all rent-free?
Yep.
We do have some funds we can disperse from time to time. Not to mention, I think we can get you a proper suit. We're explorers. We keep a lot of equipment on hand for that purpose. So the more you work with us, the more we can share what we have. We'll need to head to Mast. Check in with the Vanguard recruiting office where my contact works. And listen, whatever you were before or whatever you do once you're out there, I don't care. So long as you don't bring UC security to our doorstep. Every member of Constellation is their own conscience. Understood?
Yeah, understood.
I mean, Constellation has a roster of members who haven't always been on the right side of their respective society. We're risk takers. Some of us have seen the inside of a jail cell more than once. If you join us, it means you're committed to our mission. In exchange, we give you latitude in your choice of means.
Okay.
Good. Let's take a little stroll through New Atlantis, shall we?
You're gonna have to keep up with me, Sarah.
United Colonies to the best of your abilities, and to uphold the values of the Vanguard. Honor, loyalty, self-reliance in all your actions as members of the United Colonies Navy.
That was janky.
Sarah, good to see you. Who's your friend?
Hopefully Constellation's newest member. Thought I'd run through some legwork together.
Another space explorer. Hey, you ever think of joining up with the Vanguard? Help the United Colonies, earn some credits, even get your UC citizenship? Excellent. Just need to do a little paperwork. An orientation on the UC, a knockout an exam, and a probationary mission. We need to know you'll be able to hack it out there after all. Do well. You'll be out there keeping the peace in no time.
Don't forget, John. I need him back after you wrap him in that fancy getup of yours.
No worries, Sarah. I'm not forgetting about you or our little business afterwards. Promise.
First things first, head down to the orientation hall and get signed up at the registration terminal.
No, I want to do Sarah's mission first. The rest.
I'm listening.
If you got a bounty, well, you're gonna have to make things right with ED before we'll let you join. But if you've got any questions, I can get you sorted. Have some questions? Right. Got so wound up bringing you on board, I almost forgot.
I'm here for Constellation stuff.
No, I haven't. Come on, John. Let's hear it before you try to convince him to join the Marines.
I'll join the Marines.
All right. Here's what I've got. Vanguard volunteer by the name of Moera. Helps patrol the old neighborhood, Sol, Mars, Neptune, you know.
The Sol system? Which admiral did he upset to get that posting?
He's Martian, born and raised. Not like I can get anyone else to care. Word is he's got some fancy metal ornament he's been showing off to the old grounders. Matches that description Sarah gave me. You kidding? Lowest posting request rate in the whole fleet. Only thing there the UC cares about is Mars. And no one wants to go to Mars. They want to get off Mars. Hey, Vanguards risk their lives every day to keep people safe. So what if he doesn't understand whatever this fancy thing of yours is?
Easy there, John. We all have our sore points. Everyone agrees we need to talk to your Vanguard about what he found. Let's leave it at that.
All right. I'll let it slide. No good for the recruiting office to be seen arguing with the civs, anyway. Sol system is a lot of planets, but a vet like Moira will be checking in at Sidonia on the regular.
You mean hitting the bars, don't you, John?
Hey, nothing wrong with a little refresh between patrols. You'll have to ask him, but Vanguard volunteers have retrieval rights if they get into a scrap. Wouldn't be surprised if he found it off of a pirate or something like that. It's definitely a lifestyle, burning helium out there, seeing where the stars take you.
This is United Colony space. Maintain current course while we scan for contraband. And we're done. Welcome to Mars.
This bird on the ground. Martian landscape. Look at this place. I can't imagine being cramped down here, choking on the fumes and the dust. No trees, no grass.
Their problems? I ain't a psychiatrist. He ain't been around. Went off on patrol. Hasn't been back in since. We're starting to think it might be time to pour one out to the blackest sea. You in the service? I know the feeling, but you just get so used to losing people. Look, nothing more I'd love than to help out a fellow Martian. Especially one that's missing. But
he has a tab, and you don't know if he's coming back.
It's a lot of credits, okay? I let it slide for a long time because he's a regular, but if I'm out all that money, I got problems. What do you say?
No, I've done this routine. Let's skip to the part where you admit you're lying about what he owes.
Calling me a liar? I'll throw both of you out of this bar right now.
Oh, please. Two strangers arrived from off-world asking for information only you have. You see an opportunity. Everyone always does. Lower the price. Don't think we can't find another way to get what we want.
Fine. Come on. Life on Sidonia ain't hard enough. Don't try to guilt trip me, okay? I'm just trying to keep my business afloat. Guess I should ask you the same question. You paying or what? what? That's enough. Either pay up or get out. I'm done talking about this. Agreed on a discount, right? Let me confirm the amount. Okay, let's talk. Last time he was here, Moera kept yelling about the...
Venus? That's only one planet. Hardly an entire patrol route.
I got what I got, okay?
Fine. We'll make do.
Forget it. Let's get out of here. Maybe it's not too late to catch a ride back home.
Hello. What do we have here? See that cluster of ships? Varun Zealots. You ever run into one? Completely devoted to a deity they call the Great Serpent. The devourer of the unbelievers. I'll let you guess what happens if they spot us. No idea. They appear and attack people seemingly at random. House Varun technically has diplomatic ties to the other factions, but the Zealots are outside of their control. Or so they say. No, but I think I see something else that might. There's a UC satellite beacon hovering distressingly close to those Varun ships. If we can get close enough to it, we could download its logs and figure out where our vanguard was heading to next. Exactly. Minimal ship power. Go slow. We grab the data on that satellite and jump away. Scavenging there.
steps in, and we're already looking at a corpse. Okay, that's not Vanguard Momara. Looks like spacers were scavenging around here and someone else came in and said hello. Oh, this won't be your last encounter with a spacer crew. They pillage abandoned facilities and shoot anyone who gets in their way. They're even less organized than the Crimson Fleet. Just countless desperate groups scavenging and killing to survive.
City patched up my ship, and I'm heading to Neptune. Going to put in another request to get the fleet out here to deal with these spacers. But until then, if any of you thugs are listening, I'm the damn ghost stealing your stuff in the night. Clear out while you have the chance.
It's most daring the spacers to come after him. It's actually not a bad plan. Much better odds destroying one of their ships than fighting them all at once here.
Undocking complete, Captain.
This ship is starting to feel like home. If our instrumentation is rated for long-term exposure to this level of cold.
meet whoever you two are. Looks like we're all in one piece. Any day you walk away from, right? Now I know that kind of talk. You two Marines?
Constellation, actually.
What? Seriously? Man, I've heard stories, but I had no idea you all were this dangerous.
We've heard stories, too, about a strange object you found on patrol.
So, you know what that thing is. I tried to hawk it in Sidonia, and the guy thought I was peddling phony titanium.
It doesn't play nice with scanners. It'd be worthless to someone trying to flip rare minerals quickly.
So you're saying I shouldn't be using it as a hood ornament? Oh, that. Yeah, I mean, it's been a mess lately. Spacers, Varun zealots, plus Ecliptic tracking me down.
We ran into a few members of Ecliptic at the Nova Galactic Star Yard. I'm guessing they were after you.
Ah, damn. That's probably how they found me. I knew taunting the spacers to meet me at Neptune was a long shot. Making rookie mistakes. I've been chasing shadows around the Sol system for years. And every time I go back to Mars...
Sidonia is waiting for you. Run down. Forgotten.
Feels like everyone's given up, you know? I've just been spending more and more time in the Starfield. Sometimes I wonder if I'm really going back. Yeah? You know, that's actually kind of tempting. I'd have to settle some things back on Sidonia. Maybe hit me up there later.
If you don't mind, we came here for something. That strange object you found.
Right. Hey, it's yours. Appreciate the rescue. Hope you figure out whatever that thing is.
Let's grab the artifact. Good work. Let's get back to the lodge.
Pressure normalizing. Undocking complete.
Service, Captain.
We have it. Go ahead. Do the honors.
It fits. Energy spiked a bit, but it's restabilized.
Is there anything new showing up?
No, it's the same as before. There's a massive output as the artifact is added, then it harmonizes. Like it's waiting for the others.
That's speculation, but I think you're right. We need more. Here. You've earned this. Welcome to Constellation. As a full member this time. Well, if you ever find a relic bottle from Earth, we'll all be happy to share it with you. By the way, how would you like to keep traveling together? I'm not sitting behind my desk for this. These artifacts are a new chapter for Constellation, and I'm going to be out there for it. And I want you out there as well. You got results. I need someone like you watching my back. All right. We've got a few more leads we should talk about. First, there's an expedition that Samco has been putting together. It's in Freestar Collective Space, and he knows it inside and out. There's also the Eye, our star station in orbit. About time for you to meet Vladimir. He's been hard at work tracking down more anomalies. And last but not least, Noelle. Have we heard anything from Barrett yet?
A courier from Argos Extractors came by to let us know they're packing up the operation on Vectera. But that's it. No other word.
That's not good. We should get over there and check on Barrett in person. We maintain a star station in orbit above us. It's where we do all our deep space scanning. Vladimir runs the station. Brilliant astronomer. Years of practical experience. You can thank Barrett for that, if he's still around to thank when this is all said and done. Honestly, he took this seriously before any of us. It was at his urging that we started doing deep space scans. I will admit, it was something of a shock to see Barrett taking anything seriously. Until later.
Your father dropped by. He left a note for you. Here.
Is it really necessary for you to drag around all that gear?
I have to say, I'm impressed. You've adjusted to this whole endeavor better than I would have expected. Not that that's any sort of assumption about you, of course. There's just... well, this is all a lot to take in. We probably should have spoken before now, but I didn't want to get in the way. I'm Noelle. It's really nice to meet you. And thank you for bringing the artifact to us. Planning on sticking around then? Good. I think we can find a spot for you. And along the way, I can give you the very abbreviated tour. Right. So you've seen the library, obviously. Walter's quite proud of the collection, but Matteo has made more than a few contributions. Gardens are out the doors there, if you need a moment of quiet contemplation. Emphasis on the quiet part, at least usually. Let's head upstairs. Sebastian Banks, Constellation's founder, had this place built decades ago. It was a big to-do at the time, but most people in the city have forgotten we're here.
I hope you are satisfied with the quarters available to you.
So this is the bar. Usually no tender, so help yourself. Within reason, of course. Now, let's see about that room. You're in luck. We were almost at max occupancy already, but there's still one room up for grabs. It's been nice having the place so full. Okay, this'll be you. Common room on one side, so that'll be quiet, and Matteo on the other side, so maybe a little less quiet. I'm sure Sarah has something planned for each of us, so I'd better get back to it. Don't want to keep her waiting too long. Enjoy!
Captain, now that you are a member of Constellation, I am at your service. No additional protocols necessary. Also, given the likelihood that you will be out in unsettled space, it might be beneficial to go over exploration outpost development in case you ever need to build a base for field research. The exploration of an unknown planet can be a major undertaking. By building an outpost, you will be able to construct scanning equipment, resource extractors, and defenses. It is even possible to set up multiple outposts capable of manufacturing, allowing you to build advanced equipment. The blueprints you need to construct an outpost should already be on your watch. It will automatically connect to any available materials for construction in your ship's cargo. Captain Ronald, I will proceed to my assigned post.
Got anything you need to offload?
Trade authorities always buy. Kiosk right here for you. And here's our new captain. My crew can take a look at your ship. And you can stop by at a Trade Authority kiosk if you need to offload some cargo. You were able to land it, so I'm sure whatever is broken can be fixed. I would try the viewport. It'll be on your left once you get into the plaza. Everything looks good here. I'll be at my booth if you need me.